Scoop and Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Upon us. I still have no energy, but today I promise myself when I walk into this room, I'm going to just do this. It's a Friday!
How good to let that off my chest. Definitely did.
So yeah, without further ado, let's first do what happened in the world of gossip during the week. And of course, if there's new news, there's some new stories I came through yesterday. Let's delve into them. I have a couple of things that I really want to get off my chest. And I've been looking for the right kind of avenue to get them off my chest without people actually thinking I am biased. But hey, you always think I'm biased. Besides that, this episode was brought to you by Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. It's a good product. Let's delve. Right. So yesterday, I remember you guys had me talk about, I think it was a couple of weeks back. I was talking about this whole development channel because I'd seen it on Facebook and everybody had their different, you know, thoughts. Everybody's coming out to like say what they have to say about such, you know. I'm not going to call them a scam because I don't want to call them a scam, but all I know, it has the word pyramid somewhere and scam luckily loose around it. So yesterday the story comes out and it's on different social media platforms and apparently, because I first saw it on the Metropolitan Police's page on Facebook, and they go like, yo, this guy, it's a scam, this and this happened. For all of you who had joined this thing, it's wrong, we have arrested the culprit, blah blah blah. I'm like, what? It took that first. I didn't really look much into it. I didn't want to delve into it until someone actually ticked my mind. Someone posted on Facebook and they had this really long write-up and it made so much sense because his thing was, and this is the part where I also got, you know, touched. I was like, he was like, Ugandan celebrities, we have so much power. Okay, they have so much power because I'm not one of them, right? They have so much power to influence anything and everything. They have the power to make a regular person want to do a particular thing if they stand up and they do endorse it. So his angle was, because after the story had broken, he was like, wait. So there were names like Richard Twanje, Salvador, Roger Mugisha, Sheila Gashumba. There's a whole lot of them who actually did the ads and they were, you know, prompting Ugandans to join this whole thing. And then he goes like, you know, that's the problem. Our brands are suffering because now you see, you sign your name to something that is going to turn out in the future to be a scam. I mean, how are you helping this, your country? How are you helping this, your country, if the only thing you always look at is the next paycheck? Because we're too hungry, let's face it. According to the guys of the development channel, because we did have a conversation with them, they go like, yo, first of all, that story was false, 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 false. Before she could even go any further, I was like, false! It was on the Metropolitan Police's Facebook page, like official communication page. How's that even possible? She goes like, yo, check this out. All we know is this is how the whole thing went down. According to them, they have these drivers that they hire to drive around people and they're supposed to be paid a certain amount of money. I think the drivers also buy like a laptop. Because it's a whole pyramid thing. You have to buy something to be a part of something, then you get a lifetime check. That's the part I don't understand. How do you convince me that if I buy an iPad from you, I am going to be guaranteed a lifetime supply of a salary? These drivers have like a representative. Now the bosses would give the money to the head representative who was supposed to pay off the other drivers. Now it so happens, apparently, the representative of the drivers, Ndoze Chibalo Chari Chaga Nanga Chasika Tiramu. So the other drivers were in complaint. They were like, you know what, you guys are not giving us our money. This is not the deal that we signed, blah, 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 blah. So they got up in arms, as you know nowadays. They don't play with their money. They don't play with their life. So they got up in arms and they went directly to the head offices of, of development. And when they got there, they tried to explain to them like, yo, because they just wanted to know, does the company pay us our money? Is it this guy, our representative, that it's it? Why is the money missing at? And so when they come in, the company tells them, no, we did pay your money, but they were getting too rowdy. So police steps in, and these guys claim they were not They were not, I repeat, they claimed they were not dragged to police. They walked to police out of their own consent. The guys on Development Channel are claiming that the story that was leaked yesterday, that they were arrested, it's a scam, it's a sham, you know, the business is not going on anymore. They claim that that story was orchestrated and basically managed by someone in police who apparently wanted a bribe of 2 million shillings not to run the story. Now I sit back and I'm like, who is that dumb to know that this is a pyramid situation, which means they make money by the truckloads? Why in your tiny, tiny, tiny puny mind would you put your reputation up at stake for 2 million? If I ask for 2 million, Nebagano Zimua na soka na tweeting other story. Bwealabanga tweet JD, they call him back and they're like, yo, dude, what's good? I thought we had agreed that, you know, that story is false. He was like, my 2 million. Did they give him the 2 million? Bazimua. So they never gave him the 2 million. And then the story was leaked. Does anyone see how this is not adding up? Woo! And as usual, on a Friday, we do have a copy of the Kampala Sun. In case you haven't yet gotten the time, please pick yourself up a copy. It's interesting today. It's interesting. Woo! Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Yesterday, I think there's one thing that Bobi Wine is really... One thing I love about Bobi Wine lately is how he's so picture perfect at every moment. Have you all noticed that? Even at his weakest moment, the guys who take his photos, I don't know if it's just one of those guys who just has natural emotion about him. Like, his photos are always breathtaking. They're always captivating. It's like, hey, for all of you who didn't know what went down, how can you not know? We are trending. We are internationally viral at the moment. That hashtag is staying. It's not going nowhere. Anywho, he showed up at court yesterday. All charges were, you know, dropped, and now he's going to civilian court, and he'll be brought back, I think, on the 30th to be charged with the rest of his of the other accused. And the very first words he said, where is my baby? I was like, Jesus is the Lord. And then all of you imbeciles, all these stupid men who have not a shred of loyalty, all started tweeting, everyone deserves a wife like Bobi, like Bobi. I was like, are you a Bobi? In the Kampala Sun today, of course, they say, keeping up with people power, Bobi Wine not free, where is Bobi? That is what his first words were. Yeah, man, the letters he sent to his kids were also too high. Oh. Over the weekend, at the Rolex Festival, photos surfaced of DJ Nimrod holding hands with Joel Isabide's fiancée. And of course, the word started to circulate, people started making fun of it, blah, blah, blah. Now, when they asked DJ Nimrod, his response is classic. This guy, agenda kwa bakana buli chiram. Apparently, him and this chick used to actually date. He says, I was just giving her a hand. She showed up. She couldn't get into the premises. She called me. I went and offered a hand and I got her in. I was just giving a hand. Since Joel wasn't there, I was like, oh, Nimrod, we both know you've been given a lot more than a hand. That's also in the Kampala Sun today. But I was just helping her, her husband. How? Imagine you find your wife to be with an ex that you know is a banger. He's a club banger like Fasha Don White here, my cameraman. You know he's a banger. They're at a festival together, holding hands. And you definitely know that you, as the man who is supposed to be that woman's man, you are lacking. You naturally are very, very bad at having a full love relationship. What goes through your mind? You think they were just holding hands? Ah, well, still in the Kampala Sun, man. I didn't know Zake was a loaded guy. From money? A businessman? Y'all need to read this ish to believe it. Woo, child. Apparently, this guy dropped his very first car. Let me get it for you together. According to an interview, Zake already had 105 million when he was in senior two. In senior two, I didn't even know what 20K looked like. So don't forget to get yourself a copy of the Kampala Sun. It's been my Friday. There's nothing much happening. I'm looking forward to the weekend because I know a lot is definitely going to go down. But it's been my time. Don't forget, this episode was brought to you by Nana Herbal Mouthwash. Get you the product. I can't stop saying that. It's working miracles for me. @TinaVS1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are ScoopOnScoop and @TinaVS1. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram it's @TinaVS1 with an H. I'm out.
ScoopOnScoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Habbo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.